Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. When I published my review of the 42214 Lamborghini Revuelto, a lot of you asked why I didn't race it against the 42176 Porsche GT4 e-performance. Well, both cars use the same all-in-one hub, have the same wheel size and are very close in dimensions. I figured there was no point, performance should be very similar. But you folks insisted. I got more comments, more PMs, and even some theories that LEGO might have updated the hub's internals when they added those extra two pinholes. So here it is, a race plus a more detailed comparison between the two cars. But before we get to the drag race, let's set the scene. Side by side, they are almost identical in size and structure. One key difference? Weight. The Porsche comes at 944 grams, while the Lamborghini weighs 1032 grams, that's almost 10% more. Both cars have a slow and a fast mode in their profiles, they have different names, but the effect is practically the same. Using the trusty Technic speed computer, not the most scientific tool but good enough here, both clock about 400 rpm in slow mode and about 500 rpm in fast mode, so on paper, no big difference. Now for some totally unscientific drag races driven by my kids, they still need some practice. In most runs, the Porsche came out ahead. We even swapped the control profiles, but the result was similar. My guess? That extra weight on the Lambo is slowing it down. Measuring the hub's raw power and the load would be tricky because of how the profiles work and there's no way to apply full power directly. And yes, you can connect each car to the other's profile, the app doesn't care which hub you use. That's one reason I doubt LEGO changed anything internally beyond adding those pinholes. The biggest practical difference between the two builds is steering. The Lamborghini can take a surprisingly tight turn, while the Porsche needs a lot more space for that. If we put them side by side, it's very obvious. Now let's talk about the batteries. Neither model makes battery removal easy, but the Porsche's design is slightly more forgiving, you don't have to tear down the whole car. The Lamborghini, you have to remove the entire rear section and the roof just to set the battery free. The designers really didn't want you to remove it once the set was built. So, the moment of truth. Let's put the Porsche's holeless battery in the Lamborghini. As you can see from the flashing LEDs, the hub is working. I can of course start the app and connect it to the hub. Yes, it works with the older battery. Same goes for the Lambo V12 stickered battery with pinholes in the Porsche. What a blasphemy. LEDs are alive, the app connects, yes it runs. So yes, batteries are interchangeable and I'm 99% sure there's no real difference beyond the pinholes. You won't be replacing it anyway, as LEGO doesn't sell the battery separately. If your battery dies unexpectedly, you may be able to get another replacement from customer service. Oh, wait, that's not so easy either. If you search for the Lamborghini on the Broken PCs page and enter the element ID from the manual, you are out of luck, the part won't be found. Maybe it's too new, although the set is already in the system. Let's look at the Porsche. Here is the manual, this is the updated digital version with the pinholes, but the number is still different, very consistent, and with this number we get the same result. So, your only chance might be to email or call customer service, and hopefully they will replace the proprietary battery. But I'm sure that will only happen until the set is sold, and that's exactly why I'm not a fan of custom rechargeable batteries in LEGO sets. AA batteries seem ancient, but in these hubs I can use any rechargeable solution I want. So folks, that was the comparison and partial destruction of these two sets. Yes, I had to rebuild them for the recording of this video. To sum it up, the changes to the hub and battery add nothing new to the play experience. I'm sure for some strange reason LEGO was forced to secure the battery better, otherwise they wouldn't have spent a small fortune on a new mold. But it makes me wonder. How long will these all-in-one hubs stick around, and will we see any new sets in 2026 using the standard Bluetooth Technic hub? Let me know what you think about this and the future of the Control Plus universe. Let's talk about it in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe with notifications, because more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye!